Tonight is going to be cold. Tomorrow morning, the freezing rain could make it dangerous for conditions for those who live outside. So tonight, the Homeless Coalition of Southern Indiana opened up its white flag shelter to those in need. In fact, there's only been about 5 nights since November that they haven't opened. And tonight, they have a new location in New Albany. Jesse Cohen takes us there.
For nearly 5 years, the Southern Indiana Homeless Coalition has been giving people a warm and safe place to stay when temperatures drop below freezing. And now, in the midst of a pandemic, they are changing how they're helping people in this community.
Outside with nowhere to go. That's the reality for many homeless people. And when temperatures drop below freezing, it becomes life or death.
But at night when it gets wet and things start to freeze and that seeps through your clothes, it seeps through your blankets, it seeps through everything, you're on the cold ground. You know, there's lots of other elements and factors to it just outside of they're out in the cold.
But that's when the Homeless Coalition of Southern Indiana steps in, especially this year with the threat of COVID-19.
Because people were not going to be letting them, you know, stay on their couches. You know, they weren't going to let their friends, family members, whatever, they weren't going to let them stay there overnight on cold nights because of the fear of COVID.
Leslie Townsend Cronin, the executive director, explains usually their guests would be in one room spread out. And that's how they started the beginning of this white flag emergency shelter season, but with nearly double the amount of people they usually serve.
You know, as best we tried to mitigate social distancing, everybody wore a mask. You know, we had, you know, CDC health department guidelines with serving food and things like that. There were too many people in a small space.
With so many new guests coming in, they were worried they could do more harm than good.
And a lot of them don't spend time together. They don't see each other. And so we were having a potentially super spreader event every single time we were having white flag.
So with the help of a $75,000 donation, they were able to move to a hotel model. This weekend, it's at the Hampton Inn in New Albany.
It's a luxury. You know, they're coming in, they're getting a soft plush king size bed. They've got a TV, they've got, you know, warm coffee, they've got their own private bathroom.
This change has been the silver lining of this pandemic. Leslie says not only does it protect them from the virus, but it gives them more privacy to possibly help provide resources to those in need.
My goal at the end of the day for that is for people to say, I like this, this feels good, let me see how I can make this a permanent, you know, permanent thing for me.
These white flag shelters in hotels will continue throughout the rest of the season. You can stay up to date on where they are and how they'll be helping people on our website, whas11.com, and on our app. For the Night Team, I'm Jesse Cohen.